Hey YouTube, hey YouTube, it's me 4000 me, and I am here to talk about a book called Entre Nous, A Woman's Guide to Finding Her Inner French Girl. And I liked this book a lot. This book compares French women versus American women, or more French society versus American society, and how in America women are kind of a little more giving with talking about themselves, and as opposed to French women, they don't give up their secrets and don't invite you into their inner circle as frequently. How French women, when they go to buy clothing, they stick to brands or names and styles that complement themselves, as opposed to following a lot of trends. So it's not so anti-America like you're like, ooh, is this bashing America? It's kind of in the same vein as French Women Don't Get Fat. Let me check when it was published. It was published right along about the same time span as French Women Don't Get Fat, maybe within the same year. I like how they show how in France, you know, more of the historical perspective is acknowledged and advised, you know, with in regards to interior design. Like there's six different chapters. I can't even say all of these names, these words, so I don't want the French police to come after me. La tête, le corps, la cuisine, la maison. So I've butchered all of them, but basically they're talking about food, your apartment, your parties, your body. And just your way of life. I wish you would have put a little French dictionary in here. That would have helped. But the title on some of the captions on the cover, front covers, ever wonder what gives French women that je ne sais quoi? And then Deborah Olivier says that Olivier dishes on what that je ne sais quoi that French women seem to have and how American women can attain it. A fun, interesting read with more to offer than fashion tips. Olivier cracks the French style code and style across things more than fashion. So I thought it was a good book. But what more importantly it was for me is a jump off. Like, it gives little, I want to call them like side references or dedications to famous French people or famous famous French films, famous books and literature that describe French life. So you got, like on this page, Joan of Arc. Then it tells you of a book that you can read about Joan of Arc, and two movies you can see, a biography, because Joan of Arc held some qualities that are true to French women: being honest, passionate, and fearless. She was really the first guerrilla girl. Okay, and then they have books mentioned that you can look at French Ways and Their Meaning by Edith Wharton. This book inspired me to want to read Madame Bovary by Gustave Flaubert. Please don't come for me with all of the French words. But I took notes because there's so many books and films that you can read after reading this book. So there's like The Power of Style, Napoleon and Josephine. There's books about Josephine Baker, Coco Chanel. They even talk about the differences, how American women and French women raise their children, how American women and French women differ on, you know, fashion. Just, this is describing a French way of life. So this book has inspired me to do something I never thought I would do and read a classic. So I am going to read Madame Bovary. So yes, this book is good for a jump off. Let me see what else they can tell you. You know, they talk about the arrondissement. I believe there are 20 of them. They talk about Josephine Bonaparte, Colette. They give all kinds of autobiographies. They talk about where the French woman gets her some of her home furnishings from. Habitat, Conrad Shop. Let's see. They talk about Pauline de Rothschild. Talk about holidays that they celebrate, like Père Noël versus Santa Claus. So I really am going to be doing finding my own inner French girl. Edith Piaf, they talk about Madame Clicquot of wine fame. Because there's little statements like French girls we love. And so, ooh, and more importantly, The Food Lover's Guide to Paris. I will be going and talking about that. M.F.K. Fisher. So I am, and here's one French girl we love, Anaïs Nin. So I'm going to be checking out these people. It also makes me want to check out, like, one of my movies that I do like watching contemporarily is a Woody Allen film called Midnight in Paris. So it does make me want to, of course, visit Paris. I also would like to visit Montreal after reading this book, because that would be the closest French kind of city outside of going to France that I could get to. You know, I'm a gung-ho sucker for Canada. So I hope this book review helps you. And yeah, this book is inspiring for the jump off. It makes you want to investigate and read other books. And that's all always nice. So, hey, hit me below if you know of any other books that are jump offs that make you want to read a ton of other books, do research, visit cities, go see movies. Bye!